downtown Champaign. Take a couple minutes and greet those that are around you, but don't take too long because we've got a video for you.
Thank you. come to you today giving you praise and thanksgiving for who you are and your many blessings. We thank you, Lord, that you have overcome so much and that you help each one of us with whatever we're going through, Lord. You are there with us. And this morning, Lord, we remember people who are going through times today. We remember people who are in the hospital, some from our congregation, some from our family, and friends, and neighbors. And we ask that you bless each and every one of them. Lord, we remember today people who have passed away. Maybe it's been recently, and maybe it's been years and years ago, Lord. And they're on our hearts and our minds this morning. And for some reason, we have come to worship today remembering them. And we ask your blessings on them and upon us. We know, Lord, that you have overcome the grave. And that gives us hope. Hope for today and hope for tomorrow. We ask, Lord God, that you will help us to worship you today in spirit and in truth. And we thank you, Lord, for your many blessings. For it is in your name we pray this day. Help us, Lord, as we pray the prayer that you have taught your disciples so many years ago, and yet we continue to pray it today. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Please be seated.
The first scripture reading this morning comes from Revelation chapter 21, verses 1 through 6. About the new heaven and the new earth. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from the springs of the water of life."
It is with pleasure that I invite the children to come forward and join with me. For the children's moment this morning, we're going to talk about love today. And children of any age, sometimes I like to come forward myself for the children's moment. It's kind of a fun time. What you got there, Jackson? You got something special? Would you like to share with us? It's a cube? I love cubes. That's perfect. It looks like a plug, doesn't it? I'm glad you brought your cube because I brought a cube too this morning. And mine's not white, but it's a red cube. And it says, "Well done." And it's signed God. Yours is white, yes. And it's big. Mine is small, isn't it? It's right. It's not as big as yours. Yes. And there's a sign on it that says, God is love. And I just found this on a scrap of paper in my office that I think was left by Reverend Mary. And it actually comes apart. That is